Our next speaker is Danilo Radovich.
Have you ever thought what Tesla and pencil have in common, and how an answer to this question may help us to improve the Tesla? New Tesla Model S costs $80,000 and is still a dream for many of us. Bottom of this car is filled with a big battery pack, all the way from front to rear wheels. Production cost of this battery is $10,000 and it weighs 1/3 of the weight of the car. Material of the pencil slab is one of the two main components in this battery. Depending on its structure, we call it graphite or graphene. Just graphene is a single layer made of carbon atoms. While other parts of the battery are evolving very fast, pencil slab is there for 30 years, unchanged. Maybe that's why many of us do not own a Tesla. Luckily, here at UWM, our group created new materials that can reduce battery size and price and extend battery range and life. This material has a name, graphene monoxide. The same graphene that was left on the paper when I was drawing my Tesla, the mono and oxide, since we covered the graphene layer, is many, many oxygen atoms. Graphene monoxide. We call it simply GMO. Do not be confused with genetically modified organisms. This one is safe. Laboratory measurements demonstrated that GMO has better performance than graphene in lithium-ion batteries. But there are so many materials offered for batteries these days that it's very hard to compete with them without a simple model that would explain why GMO really works. For this reason, I make heavy computations based on modern quantum physics to see how GMO interacts with carriers of electric charges, lithium ions. Not just to say that it works because it was proven experimentally, but to understand how exactly it functions and why GMO is the best solution for a future car, cell phone, or anything else that needs an affordable, small, long-lasting, and safe battery. I really want this material to find its way to electric vehicles and be finally able to say, "Hey, Elon, give me a call."